Hello everyone, we are going to start with the topic concept of teaching. And before we start with this topic, let us try to understand that how people select teaching, how they happen to be teachers. Some of us, they have chosen this way of life, I would say, because teaching ultimately becomes a way of life. We choose teaching by making a conscious effort, and for that we tend to gain knowledge, we collect the required professional qualification, we acquire a degree, we develop certain skills in us so that we can become teachers. Whereas in some cases what we see that some people, they come to teaching by chance. Maybe that someone starts studying some subject and then he or she gets a chance to teach someone. And when someone gets a chance to teach someone, then one realizes or discovers that he or she has some skill in him and he enjoys teaching much as compared to something else. So after that, one may start developing that skill, or they may start looking for some professional degree, or they start looking for some qualification so that they can become full-fledged teachers. Whereas in certain cases, people are pushed into teaching and that becomes a forced choice. Why it will become a forced choice? Because as we studied in the previous lesson, there are certain misconceptions. So those misconceptions, they also may lead someone to believe that probably teaching is a very easy kind of profession and there is a lot of money, or there are not many holidays, or it is a comfortable process, comfortable profession. So because of that also some people, they come into teaching. And besides that, there may be certain financial constraints. Right? There may be certain financial reasons. For example, some people, they come into teaching and they take it as a vocation or occupation. Right? What is vocation? Vocation is some activity, or maybe some set of activities which you use to earn certain amount of money so that you can fulfill your economic needs. So that also may be one of the reasons that someone may be forced into teaching. There can be thousand and one other reasons also, but as far as this study is concerned, I would say that these are three main reasons because of which different people, they come into teaching. Now, as far as vocation is concerned, it is a social need. Everyone has to fulfill one's financial needs. And for vocation, you can select any of the three means. You may select some business, you may gain some employment, or you may become professional. Right? The difference between vocation and profession is this, that professionals, they are regulated by some professional body. There is some professional body which lays down certain qualifications and certain skills which are required to fulfill this responsibility which is expected from a professional. All professional bodies, they are legal bodies, they have got legal stature and they are regulatory in function. So in case of teaching, the professional body, UGC is a professional body, and for school education, CBSE or other state board, they are also professional bodies. So what is their function? They lay down the standards. So these are the standards which are laid by the professional body, that if you want to come into teaching, there should be some basic qualification which is required and you should have certain skills. It also lays down some code of conduct, right? And it also provides facilities for training. So once you decide that you want to be a professional, you have to go through the process by which professional bodies, they select these professionals. Not only this, professional bodies, they also provide certain certificate or license and maybe some professional degree also. Which gives you status and it also gives you some respect. Right? Now this status, it may be social status also as well as financial status also. Because usually it is seen that professionals, they earn more as compared to vocations. In certain cases, maybe in some vocations you may be earning more, but usually we see that professionals, they have good financial status, that what I can say. Now this financial status, it comes from your knowledge and skill. Knowledge, because you have some professional qualification, and skill, because you have been through certain trainings and you have certain skills, because of which you are considered that you have both knowledge and skill. Depending upon your knowledge and skill, you are having good financial status. As compared to vocation, where you are paid for your produce, the more you produce, the more is your income. Whereas in this case, it is because of your knowledge and skill. Another thing is that not only this, that you get status and respect, there are certain responsibilities also which come with profession. For example, that this certificate or this professional degree, it gives you certain amount of autonomy also. Why autonomy? Why there is not a lot of supervision on them? Because in vocation there is always some supervisor who is always looking at your work. Whereas when you are professional, you have certain amount of autonomy. Because it is assumed that you have skill and knowledge and you are expert of your work. So it is considered that you yourself are, you are an expert of your work. So you are given certain autonomy. Of course, you are under some regulation. So this autonomy, with it also comes some accountability. It is not that there is no responsibility on you. There is responsibility as well as you are considered an expert. Now this accountability, it comes because professionals are legal. They are supposed to do legal work and they are also supposed to be ethical. It is expected that a professional person, a professional will not indulge oneself into some illegal activity, or it will not indulge into some unethical practice. Now in your case, since you are preparing for UGC NET, so there your professional body is UGC and it will be issuing you a certificate which will give you some status, and this status, it will also, this certificate will also give you some respect. And but at the same time, you are expected expected to be legal and you are expected to have ethical practices. In case you are not ethical or you are indulging yourself into some illegal activity related to your profession, then what can be done? This professional body can be reported. Your action can be reported to this professional body and this body can impact your certificate. It may be cancelled, it may be suspended or whatever, or maybe you will be asked for certain explanation or whatever the body decides, right? So this is how the professionals work. Now in this case, what we see that by being a teacher, you can also gain some employment. In case of professional, you will be paid for your skill and knowledge. Difference between employment and professional is that employment, they get some fixed amount. They have certain emoluments which are paid in lieu of their services. Now, when we are talking about services and the payment that we are getting for it, as well as, let us try to understand that how it fluctuates when we go from vocation to professional or to employment. We are not considering education as business, so that is why I have left it out. As far as vocation is concerned, your payment is going to depend upon the produce, how much material you are producing or what is the output. In case of professional, there will be some balance between service and payment. And in employment also, there will be some balance in service and payment. Employment is usually a person's mindset, one can say, that when someone feels that I am getting this much of payment, so I will give this much of service. Whereas from professional, high integrity is expected. There are certain cases where the social good is more important. It may happen that for some individual, social good is more important. Payment takes a back seat. In that case, we can say that a person has taken his occupation or wherever he is engaged to a level of mission. So education becomes a mission also. It can become a mission for a professional also. If you are a professional, you are definitely getting some money, but if your mindset is such that you want to contribute to social good, you want to devote some time, some energy, or you have certain inclination to do goodness to those who are not able to afford good fee, or then it will become your mission. So that is why sometimes we get to hear certain statements that teaching is a noble profession, right? And sometimes we see that we get to hear that education is my mission or teaching is my mission. So it depends that how you are going to take it. Now whatever it may be, you may take it as a profession, you may take it as an employment, you may take it as mission, or you may simply consider it your vocation. Certain things are expected from a teacher. Maybe it is not expected from other vocation, but being a teacher, you are expected to have certain qualities. Like, it is expected that teacher will be a continuous learner. We expect that teacher will continue learning. His education will, he will keep on learning, he will keep on improving, so that he is able to improve his potential. Right? It is expected that teacher will be a lifelong learner. And it is also expected that you will always struggle for excellence. Why? because what you are dealing with, you are dealing with the future of nation, and you cannot compromise the future of nation or future of generation for anything lesser than excellence. So being a teacher, you are expected that you will keep on learning and you will always look for the best. You will always make your best effort to produce the best possible product. And you will have high moral standards. Or in other words, I can say that you will be always ethical. You cannot compromise with your ethics. You must have high moral standards. Why? Why teacher only? Or why teacher specifically? Reason being that teachers are going to be role models. So you will be a role model for your student. And for that, you have to have high moral standards, high code of conduct, high ethical values, so that, as we say, that we should practice before we preach. So you are going to preach, you are going to tell your students to be ethical. So first you have to have that thing in your own personality, and you will be dedicated to your profession. All professionals are expected to be dedicated to your profession, but teaching specifically, that you should be dedicated to your profession, right? So these are certain things which are required especially for a teacher and generally for all professionals. It is quite possible that teaching may not be able to give you that much of money which some other profession. Maybe you are able to earn more in some other profession. But one thing is for true, that your love for teaching, it will always remain a motivating factor. It will always inspire you. It will always be fulfilling. So I am so happy that you have chosen to be teacher. So now we will start with the main topic, that is the concept of teaching.